Hi, my name is Ruta, and I'm answering your questions about psychology, emotions, and the life situations where you feel lots of things going on, confusion and emotional charge, and you don't know what to do with it. So, and I am talking more today about crying in anger. So the question that I got is, why is anger seen as a strong emotion and is more acceptable in society rather than crying that's seen as weak? Historically speaking, the society would always associate survival with the strong and being strong. Back in the days, I believe, the people who were able to survive more successfully were those who were able to kind of like take action and think logically, or take some kind of proactive and responsive action rather than to go in their emotions. So people who would get angry, for example, somebody would invade their space in or their tribe or their area, and they would get angry and then they go to fight, they would survive. People who would get scared and start crying, they would not know what to do, they would go into their emotions and they would not survive, or they would be in much worse situation most of the time, historically speaking. Now I think that type of mentality has followed us throughout the ages, even though we have evolved as species and as society. Some people could argue in a good direction, some people would argue in a bad direction, but generally speaking, now we don't really need to have this survival response as anger in order to protect ourselves from invaders in our territory or the beasts, for example. Generally speaking, again, it's not true for everybody. So I think this is some kind of like a historical hangover, but at the same time, I'm not saying it's not completely correct. Anger is a cover emotion which is basically hiding or protecting us from feeling other emotions which are much more dangerous than anger. For example, hopelessness, helplessness, loneliness, isolation, all of these emotions would be sense of injustice, vulnerability, sadness. I think all of these emotions would be under anger. And anger is also a symptom. It's not really emotion. It's a symptom of something gone wrong or out of alignment. However, anger is empowering in one sense. Anger takes you from the state of victimhood into state of proactivity and state of like protecting yourself or the other. So therefore, I think historically speaking and societally historically speaking, anger is seen as a strong emotion and acceptable, or in some societies acceptable, in some societies not so acceptable. That's also another thing. And crying is seen as weak also because of that. Now, I think when we, if we were to kind of like consciously allow the emotions, whichever are the emotions under anger, in a safe environment, there is no danger to experience consequences of, for example, crying, right? And it is healthy to allow those emotions to be expressed that are hiding under anger. But I think it's just kind of like this historical association and archetypal meaning, kind of like a symbolic nature of what is strong versus what is weak, what actions and qualities are associated with strong and what actions and qualities associated with weak. And I think that's why it's seen as weak. I think future, fast forward, as we and if we evolve emotionally, we will not be really classifying emotions as strong and weak. We're gonna see this emotional scale, and we will know that all emotions has its purpose and uses. So I hope that helps. Have a good day.